Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. According to the American Academy of Dermatology, acne is the most common skin condition. It affects up to 50 million Americans every year. Usually begins when you're a teenager, but it can also continue to bother adults well into their 30s and 40s. How do you treat acne? Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Sophia Akhiyat. She's a dermatologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
So let's go into a little bit more detail. What exactly is acne?
Acne is an incredibly common inflammatory skin condition that affects both children and adults. And it's something that board-certified dermatologists are expert in treating.
So where is it most common? On what part of the body?
Acne typically affects the face, though it can also impact the chest and back and shoulders as well.
And what about the neck?
The neck we also do see, especially on the jawline area.
So what causes acne?
There are a few causes of acne, but looking at the development, we see increased inflammation. We see overproduction of oil in the pores on the acne-prone skin, clogging of those pores with sticky skin cells, and also overproduction of the bacteria, Cutibacterium acnes.
And so what are the symptoms of acne?
Acne can look like many different things, but typically we see the red type acne bumps, blackheads and whiteheads, and sometimes these deep nodular cysts that can be painful.
And what are papules?
Papules essentially mean bump of the skin, and we see red papules in acne-prone skin.
And what about, is it called pustules?
Yes, pustules are pus bumps.
And then what about cysts and nodules? Are those all part of acne?
Nodular cyst is a term that's used to classify those really deep, tend to be painful acne bumps that can result in scarring.
So how do you treat acne?
There are so many different options when it comes to treating acne, from over-the-counter to prescription-based options, creams and washes, oral medications that can be prescribed, and then clinic-based treatments like injections, chemical peels, light-based treatments, and laser therapy.
So how long does it take to treat acne before you see, you know, a real noticeable difference of it going away?
Acne is a very treatable and tends to be a predictable condition, though it requires consistency of daily use of your skincare regimen. And typically it takes about 8 weeks to start noticing a difference.
Is there a way to prevent acne?
That's a hard question to answer because acne is a multifactorial condition. So the best thing to do is to eat a healthy diet. The evidence has shown that high glycemic foods like processed sugars can induce acne, along with whey protein supplements and skim milk.
Interesting. So if you have acne, what should you avoid doing?
If you have acne, you should definitely avoid trying to pop your spots as this can lead to scarring. Instead, focus on optimizing your skincare routine, and you can use warm compresses if it's painful. And of course, if you are flaring, get in contact with your dermatologist for more options.
And while acne doesn't cause any serious health effects, it really can have an impact on your self-esteem, can it? It can have a psychological impact.
It absolutely does. And in dermatology, you wear your disease for the world to see. So if this is something that you struggle with, I highly recommend teaming up with a dermatologist to get the best control of your acne.
So does acne go away by itself for most people?
It can, but adult acne is a very real and common condition.
And what causes acne for somebody who might still be in their 30s or 40s?
There's so many different factors that come into play, but we see genetics, biology, medications, environmental factors, even stress levels that all contribute to potential acne flares.
So when should you go see a dermatologist to get help treating your acne?
At any point, you can seek out care from a board-certified dermatologist to have them create a customized skincare routine just for you. But I would say if you're giving over-the-counter medications a fair shot and stay consistent, though don't see benefit from consistent use, I would then make the decision to see a dermatologist.
If left untreated, what can happen?
If left untreated, acne may resolve on its own, but especially with the deeper type acne bumps like nodular cysts, it could result in irreversible scarring. And so especially for the more severe type painful acne bumps, I would immediately seek care from a board certified dermatologist.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
I would just like everyone to know that acne is a very common condition. You are not alone. It impacts both children and adults. And so it's never something that you should be embarrassed about. It's also a very treatable condition too. So please don't lose hope.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you for having me.
If you'd like more information on how to treat acne, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.